now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Confusionist, Mr. Sean Alexander.
When I was a small lad growing up, I had big dreams and aspirations of becoming a lawyer. However, my mum and dad insisted that I became a magician. Can you push all the way in for me? Can you see the card? No? Okay. Can you see the card yet? No? No, okay.
Elvis Presley,
who was an actor and a pop star of his time. Ladies and gentlemen, if I have this right, I should also have this. You can do a fancy shuffle if you wish. You can do one of those shuffles. Something like that. Don't worry, it's not your fault, it's mine, I picked you. The first thing I need you to do is to make your mind go black. Good, that was very quick. I don't know if Brad realises this, but that's a federal offence. This sign, I'm going to fold this once. We will fold twice. We will fold three times. And we'll fold four times. On the fourth time of folding, the magic occurs, ladies and gentlemen, because Brad will be delighted to know that his €100 has magically and mysteriously transformed itself into a $1 bill. Ladies and gentlemen, nothing in this hand and nothing in this hand. Unfortunately, I have come to the end of my show now. Does anybody in the audience have a $1 bill I could possibly borrow? Go ahead and point to one lemon. Any lemon wish you have an egg. And inside this egg, we actually have a walnut. So would you go ahead and take the nut cracker? Could you crack your nuts? Crack your nut. Really all the way down, keep crunching. That's it, break it up. Now, maybe get rid of those. You'll find a piece of paper. Would you remove that piece of paper, keep it in full view, and would you open that up, and could you confirm that that's €100, but more importantly, could you confirm that that is your €100?
That's great.
Are you more of an even kind of guy, or are you an odd kind of guy? Philip, you have the most important question of the evening. Philip, do you prefer it face up or face down? We are talking about cards, ladies and gentlemen. Face up. So then there was always going to be the six of diamonds. Besides a folded playing card, it's been locked away in that box all this time. Would you remove the playing card from the box, keep it on the table, and once you remove it, could you go ahead and unfold that card? Because ladies and gentlemen, I said I was going to heighten your expectation, and hopefully I have, because that is Linda's signed Jack of Clubs!